Right. So whatever I have written here, okay, whatever I have written here, this is a physical phenomena. Okay, it's a physical phenomena. Okay, between three variables. So the three variables in the physical phenomena are F, mass of ball, and the acceleration. So these are the three variables which are involved in the physical phenomena. So we call this F, M, A are called as physical quantities or physical variables because it is a physical phenomena. Okay, it's a physical phenomena. So F, M, A are called physical quantities or physical variables. So I think you have learned about the relationship between all these three variables in your physics. Maybe you have derived also. Okay, you have derived this formula also. Using the concept of physics, all these things, okay, gravity force, all these things. So, without understanding the concept of physics, without knowing the principles of physics, nothing we use, but still we are able to find out the relationship between these three variables, okay, using the concept called dimensional analysis. So we may not able to exactly find out the relationship between all these three variables, but we may end up almost approximately, okay? So using this analysis, we may not able to find the exact relation, but we may able to find out approximate relationship between the variables, okay? So generally, what is the relation between these three variables? So F is equal to M into A, okay? So we are going to obtain this relationship using this dimension analysis without knowing the principles or concept of the physics. Okay. So not only this formula, any formula. Okay. So we have seen discharge Q through Venturi meter. Q is equal to A1, A2, root 2 GH by A1 square minus A2 square, right? So we can also find out the here, what are the variables here? So Q, A1, A2, G, H. So these are all the variables in the phenomena, okay? So we can also find out the relationship between all these five variables, okay? So we may not able to exactly find out this relationship, but we may end up with approximately or close to the solution using the concept of dimensional analysis, okay? So not only any formula, you can take any formula, we are going to find out the approximate solution, okay, using the dimensional analysis. Okay, so I hope you are able to understand what I'm trying to say. So for example, that in this particular formula we have got F equal to MA. It means what do you call this F and what do you call the remaining two? Anyone? So F, MA are called the physical variables are involved in a physical phenomena, okay? And we know that F depends upon M and A. Okay, F depends upon M and A. Likewise, discharge depends upon A1, A2, GH. So what do you call this F, M, A in general? So what do you call this F in general? What type of variable it is? What type of quantity it is? Likewise, what do you call M, A? What type of variables are this? Already we know, right? So for example, y is equal to x square plus x. Okay. So what do you say y and x? So already we know that y depends upon x. Okay. So it means what? Y is called what? What type of variable it is? So y is called dependent variable, whereas x is called independent variable. Already we know it, right? So similarly, where f, what you call f here? So f is called what? So f is called what? F is called dependent variable. Okay, f is called dependent variable, whereas MA are called independent variables. Okay, all quantities. Okay, independent quantities or independent quantities. Okay, so you should able to okay in the problem they will give you a phenomena. So you should able to differentiate between what is dependent variable and what are the other independent variables. Okay, that is your job actually. Okay, so in the problem, if they give any problem, you have to identify which is independent and which is dependent. Okay, right. So I hope you are clear with this. What is meant by dependent variable and what is independent variable? Okay. So in this case, Q is called your dependent, and remaining all are independent. These are independent. So like this, should able to differentiate or identify which is independent, which is dependent. Right. So now let us try to understand the concept of this. Let us understand the concept of the dimension analysis. Okay. So what you are going to do? What is the use of this dimension analysis? So let me just put an heading. Dimensional analysis. So dimensional analysis. So how do you define dimensional analysis? Okay. So let me write the definition or the purpose. Okay, so it is a mathematical technique. It is a mathematical technique. Okay, so which makes use of study of dimensions, as a solution to several engineering problems. Okay, so this dimensional analysis is like a mathematical technique. Okay, where we use our dimensions. So where we study about dimensions and as a solution to the engineering problems. Okay, that just now we have seen that. So to find out the discharge expression through a horizontal venturimeter. So this is our expression. But in order to we have used while we are deriving. For this expression, okay. So what we have done? What type of principle we have used? We have used Bernoulli's equation. We have used continuity equation, right? We have used continuity equation. So we have used YouTube differential manometer. All those things, right? We have used all the equations, all the concepts. We have obtained this expression. Okay. But here, without using those concepts, just using the dimensions analysis, we can find out. We can get solution to the all the engineering problems. Okay. So that is our dimension analysis. So what we are going to do in this analysis, okay? So it is used to obtain, it is used to obtain an expression, okay, of any physical quantity. It is used to obtain an expression of any physical, okay, physical quantity from the various physical quantities, from various physical quantities of a phenomena. Okay, so we are going to obtain an expression for a physical quantity using from various physical quantities. What is the meaning? So just now we have seen that force ma, so these are the physical quantities. So we are going to obtain the expression for f, that is physical quantity, from these two physical quantities m and a. Okay, what is the meaning of this? So it is used to obtain expression for any physical quantity from various physical quantities of a phenomena. So this is a phenomena, it's a phenomena, the sentence is a phenomena. So where we are getting the expression for f using m and a, that is f equal to ma. Okay, so that is the meaning of the sentence. Okay, so I hope you are clear up to this, what I have discussed so far. Okay, right. So before actually I discuss about the methods of the dimension analysis, okay, let me give you brief introduction to the some fundamental quantities, okay, fundamental definitions, all these things. So fundamental quantities, fundamental quantities or variables. So anyone knows what are the fundamental quantities or variables? Anyone? What do you mean by fundamental quantity or examples of that? Okay, so in order to solve the any problem using the dimension analysis, you should know what are these fundamental quantities or variables. Yes, what are the fundamental quantities, anyone? What do you mean by fundamental quantity or the fundamental variable? So let me write the definition of this. So try to understand what is mean by fundamental quantity. So any physical quantity, any physical quantity can be expressed by a set of, any physical quantity can be expressed by a set of quantities, set of quantities which are independent of each other. Which are independent of each other and has only one dimension. So what is the meaning of this sentence? So what do you understand from the sentence? Any physical quantity can be expressed by set of quantities. So just now I have explained that you can express any physical quantity by various physical quantities. So any physical quantity can be expressed by set of quantities. These set of quantities which are independent of each other and has only one dimension. So can you name some variables which has only one dimension? So for example, if I take this f is equal to ma, okay, do you say that this whole expression is a fundamental equation? Mass is a fundamental quantity, but whereas a is not a fundamental quantity because a has different dimensions. A has more dimensions. So can you name some of the dimensions, some of the fundamental variables which has only one dimension? Very good. So length is one of the fundamental quantity. Why? Because it has only one dimension. So examples for fundamental quantities. So fundamental quantities. Okay. So first one is your mass. Okay. So mass is a fundamental quantity. Why? Because it what is the dimension of this mass? So remember that to have the fundamental quantity, it should have only one dimension. It has only one dimension. So what is the dimension of the mass? What is dimension of mass? Or first tell me what is the unit of mass. Okay, so let me write here unit and then dimension. So this is your quantity. So what is a SI unit of mass? So SI unit of mass is your kg, for example. And what is the corresponding dimension? Anyone, what is the dimension of kg? Nobody knows what is dimension. Yes, M. Okay, we write M, but we write capital M. Okay, remember that we write capital M. We will not write small, we always represent in terms of capital, not small dimensions. Okay, we represent mass as small m. Okay, that is a symbol of mass, but we write dimension as capital M. Okay, so you can see that mass has only one dimension. Okay, that is why we call mass as fundamental quantity, and because it has only fundamental dimension m. Second one is length. Length means it may be a width, depth, radius, all are called fundamental quantities. Okay, so length we generally represent maybe using small l, length. Okay, so what is the SI unit of length? That is maybe meter. Okay, so meter is a unit of the length. Then what is the corresponding dimension? Should answer Babu, because without knowing that you cannot solve the, you cannot understand the second unit. Okay, so this is L. Okay, L. So this is the fundamental dimension of the length. So that's why we call length as fundamental quantity. Why? Because it has only one dimension. So likewise, what is other example? Time. So time we generally may be using small t, it's a symbol only. So maybe seconds, SI unit. Unit, the corresponding dimension is what? T. So the corresponding dimension is t. Okay. So here, this m, mass, length, time, all three, these three are called fundamental quantities. Why they are called fundamental quantities? Why? Because this mass has only one fundamental dimension. Length has only one dimension, L. Time has only one dimension, T. So therefore, mass, length, time are called fundamental quantities, and MLT, this MLT are called what? Fundamental dimensions. Fundamental dimensions. So whereas, what do you call these units? What do you call kg, meter, second? whereas these are called fundamental units. Fundamental. Okay, so these are called now fundamental quantities. So fundamental quantities, fundamental units, fundamental dimensions. So remember that any physical quantity has only one dimension. That is, it may be M, may be L, it may be T. It has only one dimension. That is called fundamental quantity. Okay. So if I give an example, okay, if I give an example, say same, similar. Can you say that acceleration, okay, is it fundamental quantity? Is it a fundamental quantity? Answer yes or no. So what is our condition for having fundamental quantity? Any physical quantity which can be expressed set of quantities, okay, which has only one dimension. Okay, so just to give you one small definition here, fundamental quantity means has only one dimension. That is the meaning of fundamental quantity. Now, if you see here, is it a fundamental quantity? Obviously, answer is no. Why it is no? So let me write the dimensions of this. So A is equal to, what is the formula for acceleration? Velocity by time. Okay. Right. What is the formula for velocity? Length by time. Okay, into t. So we'll get length by t square. So what is the dimension of length? L. What is the dimension of t? T square. So therefore, what we get? L t power minus t. Okay. So this is the dimension of the A. So what is our definition of fundamental quantity? Fundamental quantity has only one dimension. But what about here? The acceleration has, so you can say that A has two dimensions. So therefore, it is not a fundamental quantity. Okay, it is not a fundamental quantity. Okay. So I hope you understood what is meant by fundamental quantity. Okay. So whenever any physical quantity has one dimension, that is called physical fundamental quantity. Corresponding dimension is called fundamental dimensions. Okay. So similarly, you can write for anything. Okay. So force is it fundamental quantity? No. Why? Because F is equal to MA. So MA means you will get lot of dimensions. Okay. So generally you will get only mass, length, time are called fundamental quantities in general. Right. So having understanding with these physical quantities, like what are the fundamental dimensions and fundamental quantities. Okay, so as I said before, this A is not a fundamental quantity. Likewise, force. So because force is equal to M into A, so you'll get different dimensions. Like what is mass in a dimension? M. What is dimension of A? Just now we have seen LT power minus 2. So it has three dimensions. It is not a fundamental quantity. Okay, it is not a fundamental quantity. So therefore, then what do you call this AF? Anyone? So here, AF are called. So this AF, if they are not fundamental quantities, so then what do you call them? Are called derived quantities. What do you call them? Derived quantities, because you are deriving the dimensions of AF from the fundamental quantities, because you can say that A is nothing but LT power minus 2. It means LT are called fundamental quantities. So you are getting this from the derivation of the, by deriving the fundamental quantities. Likewise, you are getting these things. So that's why AF, not only AF, any other quantities having more than one dimension, those are called derived quantities, and corresponding dimensions are called derived dimensions. Okay. So sometimes these fundamental quantities are also known as primary quantities. Okay. Sometimes also known as primary quantities. Okay. And the corresponding dimensions are known as primary dimensions. Primary dimensions. Okay. So here also, so this is also known as secondary quantities, and the corresponding dimensions are known as secondary dimensions. Okay, so here this is known as secondary dimension, because F is a secondary quantity or derived quantity. So this part is called secondary dimension or derived dimension. Okay. So I hope we are clear with what are this fundamental quantity, derived quantity, and the corresponding fundamental dimension or derived dimension. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. Right. So having understood with all this, you know, fundamental quantities, derived quantities, okay, then we can actually go with the our topic, dimensional analysis. Okay, so I hope everybody knows the units of all the standard physical quantities. Okay, so if you refer any book, if you refer any book like in Bunsell book, or any, if you refer any fluid mechanics book, you will see the second chapter, dimensional analysis. Okay, and you will, in the book, you will have a table having list of physical quantities, units, and dimensions. Okay, so I think I no need to give that table of columns having quantities, units, and dimensions. Okay, so you please refer any other book, you will get all these quantities, dimensions, and symbols. Okay, right. So just to check whether you know these dimensions or not. Okay, let me give one example. Discharge. Because we will be using this term very often in this unit. So anyone knows what is the unit of dimension, discharge? What is the unit of dimension? What is the unit of the discharge? So I'm just checking whether you know the units or not. Okay, if you are good in the units, then it is very easy to solve all problems. Is anyone, what is the unit of discharge? Q. We should
meter cube per second.
So already we know that discharge is nothing but area into velocity. Okay. So therefore, what is the area unit? Meter square. Velocity, meter per second. Okay. So I'm just explaining to some, okay, those who don't know how to get the unit of the discharge. So A nothing but meter square, velocity nothing but meter per second. Okay, therefore you will get meter cube per second. So this is our unit of the discharge. And what is the corresponding dimension? So dimension W, your dimension. So what is the unit? So here, what is M? M indicates what? Meter. Okay, it is indicate meter. So what is the unit of meter? What is the dimension of meter? What is the dimension of meter? Already have seen, right? So unit is meter, and one thing just right here, where M indicates meter. So here, what is the unit of dimension of meter? L. Okay. So what is so L cube? This is L cube. By what is the dimension of S? S means second. T. So therefore, L cube T power minus 1. So this is the dimension of the discharge. Okay. So all these things will be given in any book. You can find out. Okay, for all, any kind of physical quantity. Let me give you one more example, one more parameter, then I will. What is other class you are having? I will give you some two parameters. So please try to write the dimensions of that. Okay. Kinematic viscosity, that is mu. I am giving the two variables. Please try to get the dimensions of these variables. So kinematic viscosity, what is the dimension? Okay, dimension right down. Likewise, I will give one more. I will give you one more parameter. Yeah, I will give you density. Density, and I will give one more thing, that is your dynamic viscosity. So I am giving you three variables: kinematic, viscosity, density, that is rho, and mu. So please get the dimensions of these three variables. Tomorrow I will ask. Okay, please write all these variables, dimensions of these three variables. Okay, so thank you all. You can leave and you can. So please try to get the dimensions of all these things. Right. Thank you.